Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys about method overriding in Java, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright guys, I'm going to teach you all about method overriding. This is done by declaring a method in a subclass, which is already present in a parent class, and this is done so that a child class can have its own implementation of that method. So here's an example. I have two additional classes, a class called Animal and a class called Dog that extends Animal. So the Dog class is going to inherit everything that the Animal class has. So let's say our Animal class has one method, maybe a speak method, void speak. And all that this method will do is just display a message to the console window, such as the animal speaks. I don't know what kind of animal it is, but it's speaking. So let's create a dog object, and our dog class is going to inherit everything from the animal class. Just a speak method, really. So let's create a dog object. Dog, dog equals new dog. And we can have our dog object use the speak method, which will display the animal speaks. Now, what we could do is that we can give this class its own implementation of our method, speak. So it's going to have the same name, speak. And I'm just going to copy everything I have here, paste it. And what we are doing now is called method overriding. We're giving this dog class its own implementation of this method, speak. And we can have this method do something more specific for dogs, such as displaying a message like the dog goes bark. And if we were to compile and run this again, our new message says the dog goes bark. Now our speak method within the dog class is considered the overriding method, and the one that it inherits from its parent class is considered the overridden method. So if we're overriding a method, the overriding method should have this annotation on the top, at override. This isn't necessary, but it's considered good practice to add this note in just to let other users know that this is an overriding method, but it doesn't add any additional functionality. So if we were to create an animal object this time, animal, let's call this animal, equals new animal, and we have our animal object use the speak method. It's going to use its own implementation of the speak method, which just states the animal speaks. And if we use dog, this will display the dog goes bark. So each class is going to use the method that is more closely associated with it. With our dog class, if we removed the overriding speak method, well, it's going to next use the closest speak method available to it, which is the one it inherits from the animal class. So this will now display the animal speaks. And that's all really that method overriding is. It allows a child class to have its own implementation of a method that it inherits from a parent class, so that with this method, you could do something that is more specific to this class, such as changing the message from the animal speaks to the dog goes bark. So that's the basics of method overriding in Java. If you'd like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of method overriding in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.